Hey, what's up? My name is Seb de la Web, and I want to thank you first of all for purchasing one of our designs that we have created specially for the Flatsome WooCommerce team. If you haven't and you're watching this video on YouTube, just go to sebdelaweb.com where you can find some amazing pre-made designs that we have created for either e-commerce, WooCommerce shops, or also business websites. Maybe you purchased one because probably you're watching this video and you want to learn more about the installation process, or maybe you even purchased the All Access Pass that will give you unlimited access to all our template files. Once you purchased, you can go to the template files section at the My Account area, click on template files, and here you can find the templates. By time, we're changing and updating this design, and we try to really improve the user friendliness for installing this into your project. Today, I'm going to show you how to install a full demo. In this case, we're going to choose Adele. I'm going to click on it, and you can see we're at the moment working with three easy steps. You need to import the theme options, and then at step two, you need to import the custom CSS, and then you can import all the files, the XML files that are containing the post, the pages, and the UX blocks. I've created a Flatsome installation. There's nothing much to it. Also, we installed the WooCommerce plugin because we want to use this as an e-commerce shop. So let's get started. Let's go back to the template file section. And like I said, first we're going to import the theme options. I will just click on copy. And as you can see, it has been copied. Let's go back. Let's go into WordPress. And then here on the left, you can find Flatsome Advanced. Click on it. And then all the way down, you can find backup and import. You can erase this data, but if you already have an existing webshop, I highly recommend by saving this specific code, because if you're not satisfied with the result, you can always go back, because this specific code will erase your old theme options. Now I click on import options, click on OK. And then as you can see, the options are updated at the moment. I can have a look at the website, how it's looking. And it looks pretty okay, but it's still missing a lot of stuff. Let's go back. Second step is import the CSS. I click on it, it's copied, going back. And there are multiple ways to add your CSS. Maybe you're using a plugin, maybe you place it in the child theme. But for now, I will go to, again, Flatsome Advanced, custom CSS, and in this case, I will place it into the all screen section. There's quite some CSS, but I wanna tell you that we're using this CSS for almost all our projects. So it's really good CSS to enhance or to improve your Flatsome installation. But if there's something off and you don't like it, then it could be possible that you can find it here at the custom CSS section. So it's optional that you add this, but to get the best results, we recommend adding this to the custom CSS section. Once you have done that, click on Save All Changes, and the custom CSS is now integrated. Let's go back to Adele, to the template files, and the last step is to download the XML file. That will download it to your computer, go back to your installation, and there's a nice import tool of WordPress, by WordPress. You can run the importer. If you don't see this, it will probably say something like install the importer, and it will install a plugin first to make sure that you have the import functionality. Once you're able to import, you can drag or open up your file, and then you can import the XML file. Then it will ask, hey, which author do I need to assign this files to? Make sure you assign it to your own user, and then click on submit. Now there's a lot of stuff that has been imported. I will show you quickly. We have imported some sample posts. We also imported the pages. And as you can see, we have put Adele in front of it because maybe you have an existing installation, and by putting Adele on the front, you know which pages are yours and which ones are connected to the actual template demo. If you want to change this, maybe you want to use the journal, just make sure to, you know, take away Adele and then update. All right. So those are the pages, and we are also having the UX blocks. that we have created for you. It could be possible, and in this case, you can also see that I'm missing the actual homepage that is, I mean, it's not assigned to my homepage. So if you're not familiar with WordPress, this, well, let me just now refresh, and then you can see it's looking already very nicely, but the homepage is not assigned to the Adele homepage yet. So let's go to settings, reading, and here I want the homepage is displaying a static page, in this case, the Adele homepage, and the post page is in this case, the journal, and then click on save changes. And now when I refresh my homepage, you can see it's looking nicely. I'm also missing the WooCommerce pages. Even I have installed WooCommerce. Sometimes it happens, maybe I've deleted this, and this is just an easy trick to make sure you have the shop page, the My Account, the cart, the checkout. So go to WooCommerce status, and hopefully it's still here, still there at the same spot while I'm recording this. I think it's a little bit hidden, but you need to go to WooCommerce status tools. And here's the option to create the default WooCommerce pages again. I will click on create pages, go to pages, and now you can see I'm also having the cart, the checkout, the My Account page and the shop page. Okay, we're done here. When you have a look at the page, you can see these crazy dots. And we're getting a lot of support questions like, Seb, what are these dots? This indicates that simply the menu is missing. So we need to set up the menu by going to Appearance, going to Menus. You need to create a menu. I already have done this, but you know, pages are missing. And I need to assign it, so to the display location, to Main Menu. Now I can add some pages. Let's open up the Adele preview page. So this is how I've created it. I'm going to add shop, lookbook, journal, and more. So let's add in the shop, the lookbook, the journal. I don't see the journal, lookbook, shop. And we had more. And I think that's just a static link. So I will just put in more. And that's that. Let's save it. Display location to main menu, check. And then if you choose to work with one of our pages, I highly recommend not changing the navigation label here, but change it in the actual page section. So we're going to make use of the journal, take away Adele. And we're going to make use of the lookbook. I take away Adele as well. And now when I go back to appearance menu, it all looks great. Let's refresh. And now you can see the menu is nicely placed. So one of the nice features of all our demos is that we're creating custom dropdowns as well. And these are actual UX blocks that you can find at the UX block section. Custom dropdown info, custom dropdown shop. Well, let's assign this to a specific menu item. In this case, shop. Open it, click on design, set it to full width in this case, because as you can see, it's a full width dropdown. Then I need to select the UX block, in this case, the shop one. And if you're not sure if this is the right one, you can always go to UX blocks and then click on view. And then you can have like a quick preview how the dropdown is looking. But this is correct. And then I can save. I can refresh. And then you can see the dropdown is nicely placed. If you in any way see like a boxed dropdown, you can assign it. Let me check it again. Let's not go for full width, but let's go for a container width. Default. A custom size, and I will set it to 800 pixels. I will select the UX block info in this case. And now when I refresh, you can see this little box drop down is looking nicely. So that's really nice. I'm also going to explain you that when you open up the UX builder for a specific page, You can see these images, but the image is not loaded on your server. So you won't be finding those images in your media library. The reason why we do this is because we don't want to overthrow your media library with all kinds of images from our server that you will probably won't be using anyway. So you need to, you know, replace those imagery with your own. The reason why you see these actual images is because it's linked to the link on our server. So that's important to know, that these images are not available or not loaded or imported inside your own WordPress installation. Another important thing is that on many of our WooCommerce demos, we are also showing actual products here. Well, let me check if I have an actual product in WooCommerce. No, I haven't. So let me just create a product. Let's call it test. Let's give it a price. Let's just publish. And when I refresh now, you can see the test product is showing on the homepage, but you need to have actual products. Let me see what's more to say. Oh yes, we are having stories. So in many of our demos, we are having posts with an image, but unfortunately we cannot send featured images of posts. So you still need to, so here you can see down below, you're seeing news and stories. These are the stories. These are the actual posts that you can find here. So I created a test post. But there still needs to be a featured image assigned to this specific post. And now when I refresh, you can see the image is showing on the post. So that is also very important. I think we covered many of the great things. One of the new features that we're also offering is that you can import single pages. So if you choose to not import the entire demo, but you just want to make use of one of our great designs within your installation, you can just click on copy. Let me show you. Then you can go to, we can create a new page. Let's call this test, publish. And maybe your interface is looking a little bit different because you're working with a Gutenberg editor, but I'm working with the classic editor. So I will open up the UX builder and then click on add elements, click on import, and then you can paste that specific shortcode, click on import again. Sometimes clicking helps, and then you can see it's nicely imported. I can also click on the settings gear, set the template to full width because I'm always working a lot with the full width layout. And then as you can see, it's nicely imported. And again, here's something missing. I click on the column, going back. Let me see, going back. So here the actual products are missing. So I click double, and sometimes it helps, and this is also a little bug, it helps to first click on a product, then take it away, and then it's working again, because sometimes it's trying to find that specific products that I used to have in my demo installation that you are not using. So sometimes it really helps to select a specific product, then uncheck, and then it will be loaded again nicely. All right, so I think I've said enough. Three easy steps. If you having any problems, just go to our support section. We're having a great support team that are ready to help. We're having a knowledge base with more articles and tutorials. Also visit our tutorial sections where I'm, you know, creating videos to let you, to teach you and learn how to customize and improve your WooCommerce Flatsome theme. And if you are interested in one of our designs, again, visit sepdelaweb.com for all our newly created pre-made stuff. So thanks again for watching. Hopefully you can create amazing websites with our products, and hopefully in the end of the day you will sell better and grow your business. Again, thanks, and hopefully I see you in the next video. Bye-bye.